morning.
Good morning.
Blessing to be here in the house of the Lord. One more time. It's good to know the Lord. I'm so happy this morning to be able to stand and for myself and speak words of how I love Jesus. I don't have to have nobody. Certainly not going to let the rocks beat me, cry out that I love the Lord. Because he heard my prayer. Pity my every word. And had mercy upon me to let me live and run on a little while longer. And while I'm here, I'm going to praise him. The choir sang so beautifully, they covered so much about why we offer praise. I believe the scripture says, praise ye the Lord, heavenly hosts. Praise ye the Lord, creature beloved. Praise ye the Lord and Holy Ghost. Because he's worthy. He's worthy to be praised. I'm just so happy, I can't say it enough, and thankful to be here and worship at Blackburn Chapel this morning. The Lord has given me another chance, and I'm going to try to give him all I got while I'm here. Because one day, I'm going home. And I'm going to be with the Lord. As we all will succumb to, but it tells me that the Word of God says that we should cry for the incoming, being born into the world. Because of all of the trials and tribulations that they will have to endure and go through. But the Lord didn't leave it right there, he fixed it. He promised to be with us in our coming into this world and going out while we're here. That he promised to be with us and never forsaken us. He never will leave you. He won't leave you alone. All you gotta do is call him. If you know him, you can call him. And if you don't know him, you can get to know him so that you can call him. So much is said to the call of worship, but I'm overjoyed this morning. My soul, the joy that floods in the soul. It's good to see all your faces. If you would stand with us this morning while we petition the throne of grace with Almighty God. Oh Lord, our God, we come to you this morning. Heavenly Father, with bowed heads and humble hearts, we come to the Lord giving you thanks for all that you've done for us. And how you have kept us and you have brought us. We thank you, Lord. We come this morning to lift up your name. We come, O Lord, to lift you up high so that they that don't know you and the pardon of the sin may be able to see you as a living sacrifice for our sin. We thank you, Lord. We ask you now if you would come into We know that you're already here. We know that your presence fills the world. But, oh Lord, we want to ask you to be with us just a little while. Let your Holy Spirit fall on all of us anew. So that when we leave this place, oh Lord, we'll be able to go out in yonder world, different places, and somebody look upon us. Not see us, but see you. And we be so mindful, Lord, to give you all the glory and honor. In Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. You may be seated.
Sit down, servant. Sit down. Sit down.
Yeah.
You know,
feel in their hearts to come to church.
Amen.
To be able to worship the Lord. You know, it's hard for me. I'm an old man. It's hard for me to do these things. Because I grew up, I kind of grew up in a lonely place. I did this. He took care of the Lord.
Amen.
He showed me the things of faith that you had. That you had created. Thank you, Lord, that you sent the children and the children.
Yes.
Incarcerated.
Yes.
That's all the children in the world.
Yes.
And, they need to bless them. This is a sad world for the Lord. It's an evil world. It's a people of evil. It's the world that he created. It's a godly world.
Amen.
Evil spirit. Lord, I just want to thank you for giving me a mindset to try to do right. Try to bring this other people right.
Yes.
Thank you for blessing me, for actually making me bad, and caring for just thank you for blessing me, taking care of me. Thank you for our babies and also our kingdom. They can only read your word, study your word, and live by your word.
You
know the word is just a new token. These things I ask, you give them.
Amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
It is now time for children's church, so all children from the age 3 to 11, I would like you to line up in front of Trey.
Sponsoring a men's retreat on Saturday, 26th of May, from 3 to 5 p.m. at the church. All men are invited to come out and participate in the retreat. Men's Day will be the fourth Sunday in May. Morning service will be conducted by the pastor and the male boys. At 1 o'clock p.m., service will be conducted by Dr. Jermaine Turner and High Grove Choir. Everyone is invited to come. Christian Men United would like to meet with the following committees on fifth Sunday after morning worship service. CYF, Vacation Bible School, and Homecoming Committee. You are invited. Ms. Tori Massey and Mr. Antoine Young request the honor of your presence, and they ask God's blessing on their union and his presence in their new life together. Wedding nuptials will take place on Saturday, May 5th at 4 o'clock in the afternoon here at Blackburn Chapel Presbyterian Church in America. After the ceremony, there will be a private reception. The multiple sclerosis walk will be held on May 5th, 10 o'clock a.m. in the Village of Providence. The Huntsville-Madison County Relay for Life will be held on May 19th at 4 o'clock p.m. around the courthouse. The Cancer Survivors Dinner will be held on April 26th. Please see Sister Beverly Peterson for more information. Weight loss team, did you know that spinach and kale has iron, vitamin A, and C that can help keep healthy, that can help to keep a healthy scalp? This week, skip sugar for 2 days and keep it moving. Funeral services for Sister Rachel Flint will be on Thursday, April 26, 2018 at 12 o'clock p.m. The Unity Choir and Divine Ushers are asked to serve her. Repass is here at the church. The Youth Choir will have rehearsal Thursday, April 26 at 6:30 p.m. The number 2 choir will not have rehearsal. Reverend Virginia Washington will be speaking on the 5th Sunday at 10 a.m. Songs of praise will be rendered by the youth choir. The number 3 usher will usher. Please see the standard calendar and the program. In our special prayer list, please note those in the program. And our non-super shut-in are Mother Frances Boone, Sister Carolyn E. Carter, Sister Ella Edwards, Brother Stanley Fletcher, Sister Emma Gaines, Mother Adela Jefferson, Sister Teresa Jones, Sister Veronica Jones, Sister Dolores Porter, Sister Ollie Mae Price, Mother Lucy Russell, and Mother Estella Washington. Please remember these individuals in your prayers. I thought for today, the best gift to give to your friend, loyalty to your enemy, forgiveness to your boss, service to a child, a good example to your parents, gratitude and devotion to your mate, love and faithfulness to all men and women, charity and to God your life.
Church, amen. Amen. Our scripture reading this morning will be coming from Ecclesiastes. Third chapter. We shall conclude Ecclesiastes, 12th chapter, beautiful verses. Can I hear you? And it reads, verse 1. To everything, there is a season, and a time to be a purpose under the heaven, a time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to blood that which is planted, a time to kill, and a time to heal, a time to break down, and a time to build up, a time to weep, and a time to lie, and a time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time to cast away stone, and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to get, and a time to lose, a time to keep, and a time to cast away. A time to render, and a time to sow. a time to keep silence, and a time to speak, a time to love, and a time to hate, a time to a war, and a time for peace. What profit has he that worketh in that wherein he is, where he labored? 12th chapter, the last two verses of that. Ecclesiastes says, 12th chapter, 13th verse. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his command. For this is the whole duty of man. For God shall bring every work into judgment with every secret thing, whether it be good or whether it be evil. Thus ends the reading of the Word of God. It will be a blessing to the reader, the hearer, and the doer of this holy word. God bless you.
Thank you. morning.
Good morning.
Our God is an awesome God. Amen?
Amen.
Anybody know that he's awesome this morning?
Amen.
Y'all are sitting there, you might quiet, but God is good.
Amen.
Oh, and he's worthy to be praised.
Amen.
It is now time for our worship and our giving. Ushers, please come forward. Acts the 20th chapter, verse 35 says, I'll show you all things, how that so labor ye ought to support the weak. And remember the words of the Lord Jesus, how he said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. Please stand for the offertory prayer. Father, we thank you, God, this morning for just giving your son. Lord, you gave the best. And Father, we're so grateful for our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, as we gather this morning, Lord, we just want to lift you so high, praise and magnify your holy name. Because, Lord, you are truly worthy this morning to be praised. Heavenly Father, you've kept us through this past week. And Lord, you have allowed us to gather once again. Now, Heavenly Father, your people are prepared to give an offering. Heavenly Father, realize, God, that you are a giver of everything. So, Father, we just offer back a portion of that which you have given us. Lord, we just thank you now for all you have done, all you're doing, and all you're getting ready to do. Lord, we praise your holy name, for we ask it in the name of Jesus, and we ask that you bless this offering. For it's in Jesus' name that I pray. Amen.
many of y'all know Jesus care? Jesus care. I said the sense that music been playing, I'm not gonna say something. Jesus care. Yes, sir.
Jesus care. When I'm they get dark and die.
pray. Heavenly Father, we come thanking you, Heavenly Father, for this opportunity once again. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for the words that you have put in my belly, Heavenly Father, to bring forth to your people. Heavenly Father, we ask that you move me, Heavenly Father, and let your Holy Spirit reign, Heavenly Father, that it be edifying to your people, that they may be able to carry this out throughout their lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Coming to you from Luke, the 24th chapter, the 27th verse. And beginning with at Moses and all the prophets, he explained and expounded unto them in all the scriptures that the things concerning himself. From earth to glory. He was bruised. He was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes, we are healed. All we are like sheep has gone astray. We have turned every one of us from his own way. And the Lord has laid on him the iniquities of us all. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He is brought as a lamb to the slaughter, as a sheep before his shearer is dumb, so he opened not his mouth. He was taken from prison and from judgment, and he shall declare his generation, for he was cut off out of the land of the living, for the transgression of my people was he stricken. Here the servant is innocent and suffers on behalf of Israel, and so they may be healed. The ideal is that the servant has been physically wounded in accounts for Israel's sin and the wounds he, by his wounds, Israel shall be healed. Unlike Israel, who are sheep who have gone astray and caused problems, the servant is a lamb and allows itself to be taken to the slaughter, never protesting. He submits himself. He was oppressed, but he submits himself and did not open his mouth. Many times we as a people, when we are oppressed, we find it hard not to respond verbally to that which we are going through. But like our teachings has told us that the Lord is our strength. And if we turn it over to him, he will guide and lead and guide us in the way in which we should go.
Amen.
During these oppressive times. Many times when we have problems on our jobs, we want to fight back. But the Lord, the battle is not yours, it's the Lord's. We don't have to fight a battle because God has fought that battle when he sent Jesus to die upon the cross. Unjust, condemned, he was led away. No one cared that he died without descendants, that his life was cut short in midstream, but he was struck down for the rebellions of my people. And Jesus said, then Jesus said to them, you foolish people, you find it so hard to believe all that the prophets wrote in the scriptures. It was clearly predicted that the Messiah would have to suffer all these things before entering into his glory. Then Jesus took them through the writings of Moses and all the prophets, explaining from all the scriptures the things concerning himself. And he said to them, when I was with you before, I told you that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and in the Psalms must be fulfilled. Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. And he said, yes, it was written long ago that the Messiah would suffer and die and raised from the dead on the third day. It was also written that the Messiah would be proclaimed in the authority of his name to all the nations beginning at Jerusalem. There is forgiveness of our sins for all who repent. One thing that I often say in my message is, if you have a repentant heart, you can be saved. No matter what you've done in your life, all you have to do is repent and accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, and you can be saved. Jesus rebuked the disciples for having a slow heart to believe. They were confused and disappointed. He ended his rebuke with a question. Ought not Christ to have suffered these things and to enter into his glory? Jesus made it clear that his dying and raising were plain to understand, unless one did not have a heart to believe. Jesus also rebuked the disciples for not having hearts of faith. After he appeared to them, they still did not believe. We know the story of Thomas, where he didn't believe. He needed evidence. So he allowed him to put his hand into his wounded side. Sometimes we as a people lose heart. I say lose heart because I don't want to think that any of us lose faith. Because we know that Jesus is always there with us. No matter what we're going through, he's right there with us, just like he was there with the disciples. Although they didn't see the physical body, his spiritual body was yet there walking with them. And he tried to explain that to them. Sometimes we as people just find it hard to believe. The Spirit lives in us. The Spirit of the Lord lives within us. Who is the image of the invisible God? The firstborn of every creature. For by him were all things created, that we are in heaven, that are in heaven and that are in earth, visible and invisible. Whether they are thrones or dimension or principalities or powers, all things were created by him and for him. And he is before all things, and by him all things consist. The Spirit of the Lord lives in us. And I, brethren, when I claim to you, this is Paul talking, out with exceedingly of excellence of speech and of wisdom declaring unto you the testimony of God. For I determined not to know anything among you save Jesus Christ and him crucified. And I was with you in weakness and in fear and in much trembling. For my speech and my preaching was not with enticing words of men's wisdom, but in demonstration of the Spirit and the power, that your faith should not stand in the wisdom of man, but in the power of God. We as a people must understand that God's Spirit lives within us. It lives within us. Do you all believe Spirit lives within you.
Yes.
He walks and talks with you every day.
Yes.
And John, he said, abide in me and I in you. As a branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abide in the vine, no more can ye except ye abide in me. But when the Comforter is come, whom I will send unto you from the Father, even the Spirit of truth, which proceedeth from the Father, he shall testify of me. And ye also shall bear witness before ye have been with me from the beginning. From the beginning, we have been with the Lord, and the Lord has been with us. That Comforter that we often talk about in times of need, in times of bereavement, in times of illness, when we feel pressed down, he's with us. That's the Comforter that he's talking about, that he has sent down from heaven. He said, I'll go and I'll send forth you a Comforter, that where I am, there you may be also. This is the Comforter he's talking about. For in him we live and move and have our beings, as certain also of our own poets have said, for we are also his offsprings. For as much then as we are the offsprings of God, we ought not to think that the Godhead is like unto gold, silver, stone, or gravel by art and man's devices. Jesus lives, people.
Amen.
Jesus lives. He's alive and well. He lives in you today. Is there anyone in the house that don't know the Lord? Now is the time to accept him as your Lord and Savior. If you've been backslidden, now is the time to accept him as your Lord and Savior. For we know not the day nor the hour that he shall appear again. And time is winding up. We can see it in the different things that's happening in this world. The Bible fulfilling itself. A lot of people don't like to read the book of Revelation, where John has seen the visions of things to come. But I know from the Lord and Holy Spirit coming to me that there's things that's happening in this world that indicate that his return is soon to come. People, we must realize, the things that God has taught us in his scriptures is true. We must not lose heart. We must not faint. We must not turn from the word of God. Now is the time that we should turn to the church. Turn back to believing that which we was taught as children. The word is true. That's all I have for you today. If anything, is anyone in the house that don't know the Lord, the doors of the church is now open.